Welcome back to ProSeek Training Center. In this session, we are going to learn about an important tool called as a TCP dump. This tool is a traffic analysis tool. Now, this tool is installed by default in most versions of Kali Linux. So here you can see it's a brief usage of this tool here, TCP dump. So TCP dump hyphen H. Now, what is this tool? What can it do? So TCP dump is considered world's primary network analysis tool. It combines both the power of simplicity and power using a single command line interface. It doesn't take much of the processing power, no graphical user interface as we see it in the Wireshark. It may seem a little intimidating for the beginners because everything is command line interface, but once you start using this, you will love this tool. So what can this tool do? Well, this tool can filter the traffic based on a particular IP address. You can basically first capture the traffic which is going on in the network. So let's start that. So how do you capture traffic? In order to capture the traffic on an interface, you must know your interface first. So for me, my interface is ETH0. So after I remember that, so TCP dump. So for this, I need a root access. So I'm going to go to the root. TCP dump. Why do I need root access? Just because it's a raw packet capture. And then hyphen I ETH0. Okay. Now my Ethernet card ETH0 is receiving a traffic and all the traffic is being displayed here. Now if you observe carefully here in this one, we only see the header part of the traffic, not actually the data part of the traffic. Now this is going to help the analysts to identify, let us say there is something like a DOS attack which is going on one machine. So you want to identify where that DOS attack is coming from, or the source of the traffic where the DOS attack is coming from. So you can easily do that using this TCP dump capture. So let's say I want to capture filter based on one particular IP address. All right. So let me ping to some IP here. So I'm just pinging to a Google DNS IP address on the left side. So ping is an ICMP traffic, okay? And then I am going to implement TCP dump. Now, let us say I want to capture traffic based on a single IP address. So I will type here host space 8.8.8.8. Now you can see all the traffic which is related to ICMP, and especially the traffic related to the host 8.8.8.8 is being displayed here. So I just close this other window so you can see it a little wider here. Now, let me explain this line here. So the first one is the time of the capture. This is the timestamp, and the captured packet is a IP packet. And then this is the source IP address of that. So here it is giving domain name. So TCP dump by default is not going to resolve this domain name to IP address. If you want to change that to IP address, there is one more command, one additional switch you will have to add on the top here. And then this is the traffic which is going to 0.12 is basically my computer. And then ICMP echo reply is basically a ping reply packet. It's coming to me. So a single traffic isolation can be done using this. And Control C You can end that capture and you can see the number of packets which have been captured by TCP dump. Now, not only that, you can even capture the traffic based on a source IP address or a destination IP address as well. So the command would be TCP dump. Now, if you do not mention hyphen I ETH 0, then by default it is going to choose the ETH 0 as the interface, and then you can base the traffic on the source. So 192.168.0.1. Let us say I am trying to look at the traffic which is based on the source 192.168.0.1. Now this happens to be my gateway. All right. So I will open and I'll try to reach my gateway here. So 192.168.0.1. Now you can see all the traffic live capture is going on, and I'm able to capture it on my left side. So this is based only on the source packets. So all the packets which you see here are on the source side here. Similarly, we can even do per destination. All you need to do is change this SRC to DST. So traffic based on the destination will be captured here in this one. Not only that, now let's say if I want to capture the traffic which is coming to one particular port. So how do I do that? Well, we can do that using TCP dump. And then port 3389, for example. Okay, 3389 is RDP port. So we will be able to capture all the traffic based on a single port number. So right now there are no packets which have been actually captured on this one. Next, if you want to capture a range of ports, then the command would be port range 21 to 25, let's say. So all the traffic which is either source port or destination port based on the port range is being captured in this one. Now, not only capturing the packet, so whatever output we were seeing earlier, all this output was simply being dumped onto the screen. Let us say I don't want to dump this traffic. The real use of TCP dump is not only capturing the data, but to save the data in a file so that you can later on open and analyze the packets. So how do we do that? Let's say I want to capture some traffic. So TCP dump based on one host. Let us try to 192.168.0.1. This host data I want to capture, and I want to save this in a file or write this in a file. Do that hyphen W, and then we can give a name here for the file called gateway.pcap, and I can start capturing. All the traffic will be saved into gateway.pcap file. So let's generate some traffic again here. So I'll open some terminal and I'll try to ping to gateway 192.168.0.1. So this ping traffic is being captured. Or I would also open a browser and I'll try to connect to my gateway here. So HTTP traffic will also be captured here. This is not able to connect. That's fine. So I'll say Control C. Now 60 packets have been captured. Now where is this file ls? If I see, it is gateway dot pcap. You can open this gateway dot pcap file in the Wireshark if you want to see. So So here it is, gateway.pkf file. I'll double click this to open and analyze the traffic further in the Wireshark tool. If not Wireshark tool, you can also immediately open in the same TCP dump tool. I'll show you how to do that. So first, TCP dump hyphen r and then gateway.pkf. So here you can see the entire data which was already been captured. You can even see the data which we were trying to send it to Mozilla. You can see this one, the traffic which is captured via the D-Link router, whatever we have it here. Okay, now multiple combination commands can also be used in this one. Let's say TCP dump. So I want to capture the data related to one particular destination. So my destination is this IP address, and particularly I want to capture, let's say I want to capture data based on one port number. So I'll say port 80. So all the traffic which is going towards that machine and from port number 80 will be captured. Now remember one thing here. This data, whatever TCP dump is capturing, it is getting it from my interface ETH0. Okay, so this is, do not assume that if there is a network, you can install this TCP dump in any Linux machine and you can capture data. No, it is not possible, because in the real networks we have switches, and switches will only forward the traffic which is based on the MAC address. So any traffic which is coming towards my Ethernet interface should match the MAC address. Okay, should match my MAC address. Only then it will be received by my ETH0. Now TCP dump is mostly used by IDS and IPS devices also in order to analyze the traffic on coming onto the network. So whenever they see an anomaly traffic, then immediately they may be able to capture the traffic and identify what is the anomaly in that one. All right. So if you have any questions, you can just type the questions in the comment box. We'll try to answer this question. So as I said, this is going to be a little really short technical session related to one particular tool. So at Proseek, we train a lot of tools like this, not just one TCP dump. So if you are interested to learn more about these tools, analyze the traffic, protocols and all that stuff, please enroll to our courses and call the number which is scrolling down below. So that's all for this session today. Thank you very much and see you.